Hello my dear students, I welcome all of you to my English class. Today we will read a new section, that is poem. The poem is The Noble Nature. It is a lockdown period. We are facing a lot of difficulties, so I request all of you stay home, stay safe and stay healthy and maintain social distancing. The poem Noble Nature is written or composed by Benjamin Johnson. He is popularly known as Ben Johnson. He was born in 1572. He was an English poet. He was also contemporary of William Shakespeare. In a line, we can say he was an actor, a lyric poet, English Renaissance dramatist. He popularized the comedy of humor. He is the best known for comedy of humor with a tone of satire. He is the first poet of laureate in English literature. He has written several books. He wrote Every Man in His Humor. By this book, he became popular in English literature. His other books are The Alchemist, Bartholomew Fair, Volpone. He is generally regarded as the second most important English dramatist after William Shakespeare. Noble Nature is a good poem. Here, the poet has described and has compared man to a oak tree and to a delicate lily flower. Oak tree lives for 300 years. Lily is a flower of a day. One has long lifespan. One lifespan is for one day. So, the greatness cannot be measured by long lifespan of human beings. It has been proved many times. We are reading English poem. In English literature, so many great poets are there. I am citing three names: John Keats, Shelley and Byron. All faced premature death. John Keats passed away at the age of 21, Shelley at the age of 29, Byron at the age of 36. They passed away very earlier. They all faced premature death. They have written so many things. Their writings are very rich in literature. Their writings are praiseworthy. Their lifespan was very short, but fragrance of their talents have scattered all around us, so we remember them. Another two names, Baji Raut and Dharmapada. Baji Raut fought against British lord, denied their rules and disobeyed him, so he was shot dead. Dharmapada, a small boy who completed the construction of the Konark temple, lastly jumped into the river Chandrabhaga. Their lifespan very short, the small child, but the name and fame is very glorious, very small child. So the greatness they have left is an epitome of their nobleness. Let's come to read the poem. It is not growing like a tree in a bog doth make man better be, or standing lock and oak 300 years to fall a log at last, dry, bald and sheer. This is the first stanza. In the poem, poets mention two important names, that is oak tree and lily tree, lily plant. Oak tree, lily plant. Oak is name of a tree that lives for more than 300 years. His shape is very large and big, whereas lily is a name of a flower that lives for one day. It is not growing like a tree. That means, who is not growing like a tree? It is not growing like a tree means lily flower is not growing like a tree. It is not grows like a tree. This type of growth may be better for women. It is not growing like a tree. In bark doth make man better be. Bark means size. Here doth is the old use. That means does. Make man better be. Here the man has written in capital letter. That means poet has given much more emphasis on the word man. It is not growing like a tree. Taking huge or big shape like a tree is not important. Growing like a tree in size is not important. You can't be great or nobody will honor you, nobody will give prestige to you. In bark doth make man better be. This type of growth may be better for human beings. Bark means size. Doth means does. And or standing log and oak 300 years to fall a log at last, dry, bald and sheer. Oak tree, its lifespan is very large. It lives for more than 300 years. At last, what happens? At last, it collapses. To fall a log. Log means a branch of a tree, a large branch of a tree, log. To fall log at last, dry, bald and sheer. Bald means, you know, generally having no hair in one's head, no hair. But here in the poem, that means having no leaves in the tree, no leaves in the tree. And sheer means dried and withered. At last, what happens to oak tree? Oak tree will collapse on the ground. That will dry. No leaves will be on the tree. It will be withered. But its lifespan is very long. It lives for more than 300 years. Making the comparison with a lily of a day. Lily of a day. A lily of a day is fairer far in May. Lily is a name of a flower. Though the poet belongs to England, the lily in our country, this is water lily. The water lily generally we see in rainy season, particular this season. We see in pond, rivers or in a pit, this is water lily. But what the poet has mentioned, the lily flower, this is lily flower, and lily flower is fairer far in May. In month of May in England is the spring season. It grows plenty in May. So in month of May in our country we can see month of May in our country is summer season. Not possible to see the lily flower. We see the lily, water lily, particularly in any season. A lily of a day, his lifespan is very short, he lives for a day. On the same night, it grows, it blossoms and dies. Very short-lived. His lifespan is very short-lived. The lily flower is fairer far in May. Fairer means more attractive. It is more attractive. The lily flower is more attractive than oak. And its beauty, lily flower beauty, its beauty pleases our mind. And lily flower, it is the symbol of light and delight. Is fairer far in May, although it is fall and die that night. Lifespan of oak tree is 300 years, very large. But in case of lily, it is fall and die that night. That means in the same night, it blossoms and it falls or die. Although it fall and die that night. But the fragrance, the aroma, it attracts to everyone. It pleases to our mind. It is a symbol of light and delight. It attracts to everyone by its aroma, by its fragrance. It was the plant of flower of light. That little flower is a plant of flower of light. Here light means joy. Light means joy. It is a plant and a flower of light. That means the lily flower gives joy to everybody. It pleases our mind to every mind, each mind. Light. In small proportions, we just beauty see. In small proportions. Proportions means quantity. Quantity. In small proportions, we just beauty see. In small thing, lifespan of lily flower is very short, but you see the beauty. It delights us. It pleases our mind. But make the comparison of the oak, it lives for 300, but at last it collapses on the ground. In short measures, life may perfect be. In short measures. Measures means unity in which you express size. Measures means units in which you express size. In small proportions, you just beauty see. In short measures, life may perfect be. Life may be short, but it must be perfect. It must be noble. In short measures, in small proportions, that will attract to, you will touch the everybody's heart. A short life filled with noble action makes one perfect. A short life filled with noble action makes one perfect. Our short life will be good by good deeds. This is the philosophy of the poem. The small things can make life beautiful. Or the perfectness can be measured by person's virtue and good deeds. The perfectness can be measured by person's virtue and good deeds. This is the moral of the poem. As a whole, the poet has described or compared man with oak tree and a delicate lily flower. So the life may be short, but the perfectness can be measured by person's virtue and good deeds, and a short life filled with noble action makes one perfect. That's all. Thank you.